Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to episode number 15, Moments with the Qur'an. Today we travel to Surah Yusuf, and in particular, a lesson on how to communicate with children, on how to pass instructions across to other people, especially our children. And we learn this from the conversation between Ya'qub alayhi salam and his son Yusuf alayhi salam very early on in the surah and in the story. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that after Yusuf alayhi salam went to his father and he informed his father of this amazing dream, the strange dream that he had, you know, the sun, the moon, you know, these gigantic stars all prostrating down to him. He mentions this to his father because it was super strange, and obviously he's a young boy and these are massive creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now his father heard the dream. He was a prophet. Allah taught him how to interpret dreams. He understood a macro understanding of this dream, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for my son an amazing station and that my son is going to go through a series of tests. So in the process, he immediately engages his son in conversation with advice as a teacher and a father. And he says to his son, as Allah tells us, قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تَقْصُصْ رُؤْيَاكَ عَلَىٰ إِخْوَتِكَ فَيَكِيدُوا لَكَ كَيْدًا إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لِلْإِنسَانِ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. SubhanAllah, if we ponder over his message to his son, we find in it, number one, a prohibition, meaning a command against doing something, a prohibition. His father forbade him from something. But not just did his father forbid him from something, his father explained why. And because in the explanation was a concern of confusion, his father further processed his explanation. Let me explain this to you further. Number one, the father commands his son. Ya'qub tells his son, do not relay this dream to your brothers. This is a prohibition or a command against something. Do not do it. In the Arabic language, this lam is known as lam nahiyatun jazima. It's used when a person is forbidden from doing something in a confirmed way. Okay? In a stressed, confirmed way. Do not. Make sure you do not relay this dream to your brothers. Now, does he stop there? No. He explains the command. Right? And thus I said, we will learn today how to effectively communicate with our children and other people. We learned this from pondering over Ya'qub's speech to his child. Normally, when we speak to our children, we say, do this and don't do that. Right? We command them. But how often do we take out the time to explain why? If we say, for example, don't go outside, have we explained why? I don't want you to have those friends. Go and study. Right? Do we spend time explaining why? Because in explaining why, you're going to achieve results. Number one, you're going to teach the child that the child is important and that you respect the mind and intellect of the child. Right? This is number one. Number two, you allow for the child to make an informed decision himself or herself, which means they have emotional buy-in into the command, which means they have extra motivation to fulfill what they are being instructed to do. He took out time to explain to his child. He said, if you do so, if you do not listen to me and you relay the dream, they will plot against you. Now, obviously, this brings another quandary, another issue. What's the issue? All my life, I've been teaching my son about unity. And my son's young. Yusuf alayhi salam was very young. Some of the scholars of tafsir pivot him to be below the age of 7 or between the age of 5 and 7 when this conversation is taking place. And this highlights to us, subhanAllah, that we should also always be raising and nurturing and teaching our children. We should never ever feel they're too small to learn. Right? Especially when it comes to matters that they need to know now. In the Sharia, there's a rule about ta'khir al-bayan and waqt al-haja, delaying explaining something past its point that it has to be known. This is forbidden. Right? So the scholars discuss it, that can Allah command us to pray and then not teach us to pray before the command to pray kicks in? They say this can't happen. Right? So in the same way, even with other people, if they need to know something, we have to tell them immediately. We can't say they're too small to know and let them ride the wave uninformed. No, knowledge is power. So Ya'qub knows that I've been teaching my son about unity and about, you know, the blood relation and how we all protect us to each other and so on and so forth. But now I'm giving him an instruction that goes against everything that I've taught. So no doubt my young son will be in a state of some confusion. So he goes on to teach his son and he says, you know what, my son, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لِلْإِنسَانِ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. That my dear son, never ever forget that indeed shaytan to mankind is a clear enemy. It's as if Ya'qub is saying, your brothers are your brothers. They are your blood. You share the same blood. They are your protectors. But sometimes issues can happen whereby shaytan gets the better of somebody's circumstance and situations, and they do things that they're not supposed to do. They do things that they know they should not do. Now, this is not Ya'qub saying that your brothers are absolved from any consequences or crimes or sins and so on and so forth if they do what they do. No, and we know this from the rest of the story, because at the end of the story, they told their father, ask Allah to forgive us, right? But he's telling his son that, my dear son, they will be wrong for what they do, but don't forget shaytan's role in the matter. And this helped Yusuf alayhi salam as a young boy forgive his brothers from the time they committed the crime against him by stealing him from his home and throwing him into a well. Because we know later on, when he's the minister of Egypt and now it became apparent who he was and they were in shock, immediately he said, لا تثريب عليكم اليوم. There's no blame upon you. I'm not telling you who I am for you, for me to see all these regretful faces. خلاص, it's done. You are my brothers. يغفر الله لكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you and continuously forgive you, and he's the most forgiving, the most merciful. And the fact that he's saying that, he's telling them that I've already forgiven you. Because we know that if you harm somebody else's rights, Allah won't forgive you unless they forgive you. So by him telling his brothers that, please, there's no blame on you, I'm not informing you to blame you, and Allah will forgive you, he's telling them that I've already forgiven you, basically highlighting to us all that I understood my father's perfect instruction when he warned me against telling you about the dream, and he explained to me why, and he explained to me further that shaytan to mankind is a clear enemy. I love you all for the sake of Allah. Until our next moment, improve your communication with your children and others. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.